So what goodies are there in there for us to do here? Starting with what we have in the archives, the first couple rows of shelves are organized by apparatus manufacturers, going alphabetical. Here we've got American with France, Emergency One, Big Macs down on the end. This includes sales literature, photos, some drawings are included in here, some operators' manuals. This is one of the major steps that
spec sheets.
There's some spec sheets. This is one of the major steps that, in terms of having this material indexed, so this way, if you want to find out if we have information about your rig or if you're doing research on a particular topic, it may be in there. Right now, we can't really tell you what's in there. So that's part of the enormous project we have. This is the other side of the apparatus aisle coming up to work in France. And one of the things we did to help make it more searchable is Professor Heber in his best font labeled up what we have there once we started getting it organized. What's really important here with the way we spread this out too is all this was pretty much in one row at ATHS. We have now spread it out over a couple rows. It gives us that room to grow without having to move stuff again and push it around. This is a great aisle. What's the name of the collection?
Glendy Colbert.
Glendy Colbert is a sales representative for?
He was American Squire.
Hirsch.
Seagrave.
Not Seagrave.
No, what was it?
No, that was Tuscan. And later in life, he won.
And he apparently donated a lot of materials to us. This whole aisle is materials that he donated to us. We have to, again, catalog those and identify what's in there. They're really, as far as we can quickly tell, not in a particular order, but we'll be able to get that resolved. The next aisle, this is photos that aren't yet in order, and it's going to take a while to get them in order. The photo that we do have in order, this is the Maxim collection. Factory photos. Unfortunately, we didn't get all metal shelves, and we had wire ones with shelf liners. They're not able to carry the full load of these boxes of Maxim photos, which have been organized, and I don't believe, at least we didn't find, that we had an index corresponding to their numbers, but Howard Smith and his father put those in order, so we do have a very well organized Maxim collection. With periodicals is the next aisle, and then books. This is about half of what Tom Scott donated to us. There's ones on the back side and then running into the next shelf. They're organized by fire department histories, apparatus manufacturers, insurance,
technical specialties.
So that's just a quick overview to give you a little bit more in depth. One of the things I was surprised to find, even though I've researched in the archives at Hershey, I didn't realize the scope and variety of historical documents that we had. We've got some stuff from the Button Fire Engine Company. You don't see that too often. And you see information here that if you have any interest in steamers, this will probably be of interest to you. I was surprised to find that this test questions to ascertain the competency of an engineer for a fire department operating a steam fire engine. And Steve Heber and Ted Elder are going to take this written test this weekend, and I'm going to see who scores better on it. And but reading it, the questions and the answers, it's really interesting to see that this is a very early training manual, going back to probably about 1900, where there really wasn't standardized
training.
I've never seen anything before from the Gould's Manufacturing Company. We've got some material from them. We've got material from the American Fire Engine Company, parts lists, nozzle sizes. We also have, and this is where the collection is not organized or segregated along strict lines, because in the section that is by manufacturers, there's a lot of sales materials and stuff that I've just been showing you, but there are some photos in there, including these ones from the American Fire Engine Company, or what's probably fireboat pumps, and this one that looks to be much older than the 1900 date on the photo. We've got lots of sales literature. Old stuff from America and France, stuff from other manufacturers like Wiley's Jeeps. We've got Seagrave. We even found some Crown.
Yeah.
We should have put that in for our friends from California. Old sales catalogs, and I'm partial to the really old stuff, and finding stuff in there that is excerpts from magazines, not necessarily sales brochures, but stuff that's been cut out. We have a lot of photographs. I can't say, I don't think any of us could really put a number on it. I'm going to say probably more than 20,000, but less than 50,000. And some of them are very well organized. We
have the Edelman collection?
We do not have the Edelman collection. Do we have photos by Dick Edelman? Yes. We have a small portion of the Wayne Sorensen collection. My understanding is the balance of his collection is at the San Jose Fire Museum, but I found we had some binders, and it looks like Mr. Sorensen donated to SPAMFA his American of France ones, which I'm not sure what the reason was that we got just those, but those are amongst the more organized photos that we have. Ed Haas donated, I believe there's 18 or so of these smaller binders that are well organized with photos. Some of them are the binders that we have with photos, with photo albums, but like this one, nicely organized. No information. There may be information in the back, but we're going to have to go through, remove the photos to be able to digitize them and hope that there's information behind them. Some of the other photos we have are just like this. Jammed into drawers, some of them are cardboard that we're going to have to be replacing. Those boxes, these are organized by states. There's varying degrees of information on them. It's terribly exciting, but going to be a lot of work for us to be able to get through. The variety of photos we have go back to hand-drawn apparatus. We've got some unique chemical apparatus, horse-drawn stuff, and then photos of apparatus responding. And I put this in chronological order to give you an idea of the breadth of what we have. There's some photo albums, we haven't been able to figure out who donated them, that have this wonderful old handwriting here and a variety of photos. None of them appear to be later than from 1930, looking at the apparatus that's in there. There's some stuff from Albany, New York. I'm partial to that because I recognize these companies with their modern apparatus. We've got photos that Ed Peterson was able to go through with some volunteers. The K in the lower corner here, this is from the Kimball collection, which is pretty well organized and pretty well cataloged. Some of the photos we have provide sort of intriguing mysteries. Ted and Steve and I were looking at this photo last night trying to figure out who's Watertown. I think they concluded it was a Seagrave. I thought it was a Hale. I don't know my Watertown as well as they do. So some of the photos there, we're gonna be able to, for example, categorize this as a water tower photo, but hopefully we'll be able to ascertain where it came from. We've got a nice variety of photos of steam fire engines in action, and also a lot of American of France photos. There is a collection that Type 19 came from, and we got the information on the back. If everything was this way, the organization, digitization, of the collection would be terribly easy, but unfortunately, not everything's quite that way. We have factory photos from American of France and Seagrave. We also have a very nice selection from what I can tell, the collection of unusual apparatus, which I'm quite partial to. A few pieces. This Mack car is actually in the New Jersey Fire Museum. I thought the burning would be here, so I made sure to put this in for them. We've got pieces that are lost, like a Galloping Ghost. This, I believe, is a Jack Lurch photograph. And factory photos, odd stuff, like Turbo Chief, Seagrave, excuse me, Eagle platform. I've never seen a fully enclosed cab on a canopy cab on a Mack C before. Ford C before, so that was exciting. And then one of the other things that we have in the photos is Spamford is about, and we spent at the planning meeting yesterday a while talking about what's our mission, working on a mission statement. Part of what was covered in the archives, and I think it's part of the firefighting, fire apparatus story that we tell, is firefighters. And there is a fair amount of photos that have apparatus and firefighters. And fortunately, these we have good captions. We also have a fair number of photos of fires, some of which we're able to identify against, some of which we're not. There's a lot of stuff from Baltimore, which Professor Heater, I have to get him copies of those. We've got a lot of 3x5 photos. These photos here and the buffaloes here that I put in as a nod towards Peter, you already have those. Those come from, we've got a couple banker's boxes that are just literally full of photos. Again, some unidentified. We don't have quite as many color photos of older apparatus, but we do have quite a bit of photos of more modern apparatus. Slides. I think there was a box. Well, I know there's a box. I think the number on it said that there was 9,500 slides in. One of the things we're going to be doing to be able to digitize the collection is get a bed scanner, and that should be able to, will be able to scan the slides. Where to start with 9,000 slides, I'm not sure. There's some surprises in there. I found this photo of Vice President Elder from 1914. And actually talking about Chief Elder's hat over there. ATHS collects small artifacts, and that picture, one of the photos I had over there, there was a pile of boxes to the side that someone's model collection. We are not accepting small artifacts. We are more a research library archives. One of the things that we've written into the draft session policy for the archives is unless it's something rather extraordinary, we're not taking small artifacts because we just do not have the room.
Well, magazines.
Magazines are not small artifacts. If it's on paper, it's something that we would want. And that includes postcards. One of the things that we have is a complete collection of the set of Providence postcards from about 1908. I was impressed with that. We have a large amount of real photo postcards that were popular between, with the divided backs between 1909 and about 1916. Some of them have apparatus, some are fire stations. Some, like this one from San Angelo, Texas, have fire stations with fire apparatus, and in this case, horse-drawn and motorized. Our flat files, the lowercase here is pretty much filled with drawings. They're not in any particular order. There's American of France, Seagrave.
Well, we started to sort them by date.
Okay.
So they are somewhat ordered.
Okay. We're going to need another one of these cabinets soon because we have a lot of drawings, and with big architectural drawings, big sheets, you can't keep them quite as packed as we have in there. And that's one of the things that we have to deal with in the near future. We've got a lot of operators' manuals, and this is one of the resources, even if you don't want to research it and find out the story of your truck, you just need to be able to fix it. One of the things that we will hopefully be able to get online sooner than later is our catalog of service manuals, operator manuals. We've got a lot of periodicals. Our magazine collection includes fire engineering from 1930 up to the present. We have a lot of WNYF. We have our favorite magazine, Engine, complete collection of those. And this is our periodical aisle. So that's all magazines. In terms of accepting donations of magazines, this is probably the area that we're least interested in because our collection of firehouse, fire engineering, engine, those are rather complete. If it's something that we don't have, we would want it. And this is why part of the policy that we have already in place and will continue to have in place is if someone has a donation they want to make, to contact our archivist, Ed Peterson. And Ed's pretty knowledgeable about what we have, so right off the bat, he could probably say if we have the magazines and don't need them. Now, for books, we have in the library so far from what Dr. Tom Scott's donated to us, we have some of the basic books. We have some really new and exciting books. I was kind of happy when we were unpacking the new stuff that arrived, and I saw that Ed had put my book in here because I had donated it. And then some wise guy, was it you, say something about we're not allowed to shelve it? And for those of you who don't know, I wrote a book about buckboard fire apparatus, which is illustrated. Probably about 3/4 of the photos are from the archives. Yes, and there are copies here for sale. Thank you for pointing that out. We have a lot of department histories, big city departments, and books that you see on eBay for a lot of money. They're in that collection. So in terms of research, these are things that would be rather accessible.